Simbin it so much better to be free of God, so we would talk in James version 16. He went in and the Lord said unto Moses, be dark and go up and foul and foggy, the which thou hast brought about of the land of Egypt unto the land which I swear unto Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, saying unto thy seed will I give it, and I will send an angel before thee, and I will drive out the Canaanite, the Amorite, and the Hittite, and the Perizzite, the Hivite, and the Jebusite, unto a land flowing with milk and honey, for I will not go up in the midst of thee, for thou art a stiff necked heathen, lest I consume thee in the way, and when the heathen heard thee's evil tidings, they mourned, and no man did put on changes ornaments, for the Lord had said unto Moses, say unto the children of Israel, ye are a stiff necked heathen, I will come up into the midst of thee in a moment, and consume thee, therefore now put off thy ornaments from thee, that I may know what to do unto thee, and the children of Israel strip themselves of their ornaments by the Mount Horeb. And Moses took the tabernacle and ditched it without the tent afar off from the tent, and called it the tabernacle of the congregation, and it came to pass that everyone which sought the Lord went out unto the tabernacle of the congregation which was without the tent. And it came to pass when Moses went out unto the tabernacle, that all the people rose up and stood every man at his tent door, and looked after Moses until he was gone into the tabernacle. And it came to pass as Moses entered into the tabernacle, the cloud did descended and stood at the door of the tabernacle, and the Lord talked with Moses, and all the details of the cloud did stand at the tabernacle door, and all the people rose up and worshipped every man in his tent door, and the Lord spake unto Moses face to face, as a man speaketh unto his friend, and he turned again into the tent. But his servant Joshua, the son of Nun, a young man, departed not out of the tabernacle. And Moses said unto the Lord, see, thou sayest unto me, bring up this people, and thou hast not let me know whom thou wilt send with me, yet thou hast said, I know thee by name, and thou hast also found grace in my sight. Now therefore I pray thee, if I have found grace in thy sight, shew me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation is thy people. And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. And he said unto him, if thy presence go not with me, carry us not up hence, for wherein shall it be known here, that I and thy people have found grace in thy sight? Is it not in that thou goest with us? So shall we be separated, I and thy people? come from over deep upset, or upon the face of the earth. And the Lord said unto Moses, I will do this thing also, that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name. And he said, I beseech thee to me thy glory. And he said, I will make all my goodness as before thee, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee, and will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and will to mercy unto my will to mercy. And he said, thou canst not see my face, for there shall no man see me and live. And the Lord said, behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock, and it shall come to pass while my glory passeth by, that I will put thee in a cliff of the rock, and will cover thee with my hand while I pass by, and I will take away mine hand, and thou shalt see my back marks, but my face shall not be seen.